NASA has just decided to abandon one of the most historic structures in America, the launch pad where the first journey to the moon began. Launch Complex 39A was also the starting point for many shuttle flights.
WESH 2's Dan Billow takes us on a subterranean trip underneath that pad, where today he uncovered some of the lost secrets of Apollo.
Far beneath the tower of steel and mountain of concrete at Launch Pad 39A is a place rarely visited, a place that feels claustrophobic. Smells dusty, looks abandoned. Back in the days when the echoes of Saturn V rockets boomed across the space coast, our old heroes were risking their lives to go to the moon. In the back of every mind was always the possibility that the Saturn V could explode during fueling. That's why these subterranean escape tunnels were built.
There was about 1 kiloton of explosive power up on that pad.
An astronaut or launch pad worker would come zooming out of this tube here after about a 9-story drop. And in this room, almost everything is rubber. They'd slide along this runway until they came to a stop. From here, the Apollo crew would go into the blast chamber with concrete walls 4 feet thick. They'd strap into a steel seat and hope to survive. I toured these forgotten underground passages for the first time because NASA is about to turn out these dim emergency lights for good.
Emotionally, it's very hard for people. We've had people that have spent 30, 40 years babying this system.
The launch pad was to be used for NASA's planned super rocket, but now those future launches will be limited to Pad 39B, the other former shuttle and Apollo launch pad. So the future of this pad, where Armstrong, Aldrin, and Collins set sail on Apollo 11, may be to do nothing but rust until nothing is left but the echoes. At the Kennedy Space Center, Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.